Woke up this morning, no water. Water pump's not making any sounds. Water tank, it still has a decent amount of water in it. However, and it's liquid, it's moving around. However, the pipes are frozen. So, we out here, it's 9 degrees. The wind is whipping, it's extremely cold. We have no water, but we gotta fix it. Temperatures dropped overnight. The heater was on, but it wasn't enough. The temperature wasn't at like 40. You know what I mean? It just overpowered the furnace. So we turned the furnace up here. We got the room set to 80. You can adjust this in the room downstairs. This furnace goes not only from in here, not only from in the actual living space, but also it goes, it's ducted under there. So we turn that up a bit. Hopefully that heat pumping throughout the underbelly of the cab will start to thaw some of these things out. Now, it may take about 12 hours just doing it this way because we're fighting against Mother Nature again. Because we see no explosions, we see nothing broke, that's a good thing. Now here's the key. You wanna make sure that this water pump is off. When you turn this water pump on and if it's frozen, you can actually damage your water pump. So we're gonna keep that off. We're gonna keep this up and we're gonna keep the furnace burning throughout the underbelly of the entire carriage while we go figure out the next step, which could be space heater. I know it sounds weird, but a space heater is something that you put in there, you run from the electric outlet, you run it outside, you close that enclosed space that we were just under, you let that heat that area up, and hopefully the temperature of that space heater positioned accordingly will heat that small space up enough for those, that water that's in those pipes to defrost, and we'll go from there. So we're gonna shoot over to Camping World again, which has been like my favorite spot on this whole trip. We'll shoot over there, get a space heater, take the next step. You'll be stiff as a log in a suit looking nice. You're the sinner, nigga. You're as cold as ice. But you ain't cold enough to freeze hot slugs when they run up in ya. You ain't in my class, nigga. I'm the last, nigga. You gon' fuck around and get blast, sucker ass, nigga.
Really? The only two options you kind of have is getting a heat tape that you can wrap around there and plug in and keep those lines warm and thaw them out. Mm-hmm. Or say a space heater to warm up that compartment to keep that area warm and thaw those lines and then get water flowing through back. And just plug it in and it'll keep them warm.
Perfect. All right. Thank you, Steve.
Absolutely. Appreciate you. Have a great day, guys.
You too. We got our marching orders. We're going to go get a space heater here, like Big Daddy 2 Ray said. Because we were outside and it's extremely cold, we're gonna do some extremely cold stuff. Mother Nature doesn't care about your money. Either you can become resourceful, learn, ask questions in areas of things that you don't know and apply that information, or you'll freeze to death. At the end of the day, you are responsible for you. You may have some help, but nobody's coming to save you.
See, I'm for real. We're delivering these MOP tactics. I'll bury you bastards. I custom make caskets to BG.
Soldier nigga.
The YG.
Soldier nigga.
Even the OG.
Cobra nigga.
Soldier nigga. I may come with my gun in my hand to make sure you motherfuckers understand.
Pardon me. How the fuck you gonna stall with me? I'm a heavyweight in this game. You just fall with me. You get laced down from your face down. Drop your shit. Niggas throw them on peace, stand for mopping shit. Don't get it twisted. I told you that we top of the line. Design realistic. For instance, mash out my side. We'll come through and clear your ass out. Dump and air your ass out. Jump, we cold.
You're as cold as
so we let it sit for a little while. We got the cord here on some jerry rig hanging out the window. I don't know if it's gonna work yet. Let's see if we solve it with this, you know, little trick, or if we got it something else at hand.
You see my work, you know my.
So in essence, what just happened was we got that heater in that space, ran the electric cord, heated up that space itself, turned the furnace on, let the heat from the engine and the propane furnace fall out those pipes, and we're gonna keep it running for that time. Little step. Little bit of cold, but it's worth it. The biggest issue is to make sure that when you're doing things like this, whatever you're diagnosing, you have to be able to be willing to try things, ask people that know more than you, trial and error, and now prepare afterwards so it doesn't happen again. You learn from the growing pains. It's not called growing cute. It's called growing pains. You grow through it, you learn, you never have to run into that issue again. Be safe, be solutionary.
Yeah!
You're really-